Are you ready?
I am so confused by my reaction to this song. I'm Finn.
I'm sorry.
And this is...
The Tragically Hip, It's a Good Life If You Don't Weaken.
That is such a long...
For...
Thingamajig.
I know, for a long-standing front. Well, I wasn't actually sure which one was the band name. Imagine if It's a Good Life If You Don't Weaken is the band name. Anyway, this
I
is
think
for...
it's the Tragically Hip.
Mook Meh.
Mook Meh.
Shout out to the big homie who's going to be giving us some really cool music, hopefully this summer. His band is going on a recording binge, is my understanding.
Not if all band does it first. So Mook Meh is a pretty special guy to the channel. And, oh, by the way, so this is going to be one of his last requests for quite some time. But, Mook, it is not going to be one of your last requests because,
You have to send us one of your songs.
You got to send us one of your songs to review, my guy. You have to. We'll promote your band, blah, blah, blah. You've been a friend of the channel, so, shoot us your band, right? And, we'll review it for you. And don't get all emotional and say we're being nice to you. Stop it. You know you deserve it. Anyway, Mook Meh's band's coming. They're coming soon. Check it out. We've also got another band, Fist of Five, one of the best bands of all time, in my opinion, who they've written a pretty ridiculous record. I've been getting some exclusives because I have a bunch of famous friends. What can you say?
Yeah.
I got Mook Meh. We've got Mook Meh on the list. We've got Fist of Five. We've got...
Don't be jealous.
You know, don't be jealous. Hey, start your
we
own channel.
We also talked to Lindsay Schoolcraft.
If you, dear listener, would like your song reviewed, it's very simple. 125 gets you straight to the head of the line.
It does.
You do it three times, you get bumped down to the $75 rate like the big homie Mook Meh. If you've got a personal band or a band that you're trying to promote, send me an email, vinansori@gmail.com.
Reach
we'll
out to
explain
on Patreon. Patreon
to you
has
how
the,
to do it. Yep.
The tier for that. So
we're filming right now for a miniseries that we're going to be putting out. I don't know where we're going to put it out, or what form we're going to put it out on, but we're... You guys, if you're following on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, you guys know that we're starting an Amazon online business, and it's wreaking havoc in our family. Holy moly. Hopefully one of us will be alive to reap the benefits of it. It's
right,
a good life if you don't weaken. Let's go.
improvisational skills on a forest of whispering speakers. Let's swear that we're well. Get with the time in a current health to stay. And let's get friendship right. Get life day to day. And the forget yes, Kate's dream. Full of countervailing woes, as diverse as ever seems. Proceeding on a need to know, a face so full of meaning as to almost make it glow. For a good life just might have to weaken. Find some.
This song is completely inexplicable to me. This song is... Orbit Culture song at the end of 2020.
Mm-hmm.
The Shadowing.
Mm-hmm.
That's my favorite song of 2020.
Yeah.
I've probably literally listened to that song 65 times.
At least.
Got the guitar parts down.
Mm-hmm.
When we start touring, I want to do that song.
That cover? Cool.
Well, I want to do like a remix of that song.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
All right.
Well. This song, I'm going to play 158 times in a row. I love this song to death, and I have no idea why. I have no idea why I love this song so much.
I know. I told you it was like trippy. It like took me somewhere.
And I love the singer.
Mm-hmm.
And he was very kind of, like, reserved. He wasn't very demonstrative. But, like, if you really look at him, like, when he was singing, like, he was going for it. Lyrically, I loved it. Like, this is, I'm really, really, really weirded out by how deeply this song affected me. And I don't know why. It's
I'll have to go back and watch the review.
It's very strange. It's very strange. Like, I don't think I'm going to have a lot to say about the song. It's just...
Yeah.
One of the best songs I've ever heard in a very, very long time.
It, like, spiraled me down.
I love the guy's mannerisms when he sings.
It, like, spiraled me down and pushed me on, like, this smooth, I don't know, getaway. I don't know. It was... I'm using the word trippy because I don't know how else to explain it. It was just... It just took me somewhere. And I was very surprised because... Like Pink Floyd, when you hear playing Pink Floyd, you're like, kind of that makes sense why that would kind of take somebody somewhere. This one, it was almost kind of like basic but deep at the same time. Like, yeah. It's like it switched to like another, I don't know, sound really weird, but it felt like, I don't know, well, like another dimensional. Like, I went somewhere else. I don't know how to explain it. I really liked it, though.
Yeah, I mean, I've got my shower. And my ritualistic pre-shower plank. And I'm just going to listen
to
this song
playing
over and over and over again. I have no idea why. Somewhere to go. I don't know. Not a very challenging song at all, vocally or
instrumentally. I know, that's why I'm so surprised that you like that.
I have no idea why. I have no idea why. There's only 2 million hits on this thing on YouTube?
Yeah.
Like, that shit is crazy to me, bro. Yeah, like, honestly, honestly, you're going to be disappointed by this. Like, I'm not even going to listen to any other songs tonight.
What?
Like, we're slated to listen to something else. That's how, because I would just be mailing it in. I wouldn't even be really listening to the other band, and I never want to do that on the channel. I never want to mail something in, like, if I can avoid it. And, like, because I would be so stuck in the world of this song. I don't know why. I have no idea why. It's almost like, if I look at the lyrics, I am probably certain that I could figure out why this song is so deep to me, and I'm probably purposely looking away from it.
Okay, I'll tell you, there's something about it that's tragically familiar.
Yeah. Well, they're called the Tragically Hip. That's interesting. An interesting name for a band.
Tragically Hip. I might have seen the word tragically, and that's why that came into that phrase that I just made.
I love, like, just this guy's prose, the way he writes, when the color of the night and all the smoke for one life gives way to shaky movements, improvisational skills, a forest of whispering speakers, let's swear that we will. Get with the times and a current health to say, let's get friendship right, get life day to day. I don't know. In the forget your skates dream, full of countervailing woes, as diverse as ever seen, proceeding on a need to know. That line was pretty deep to me, proceeding on a need to know.
Yeah.
Because that's been the story of my life for the last, I don't know, almost 8 years. And that's a really difficult thing to do, man. Mm-hmm. It's especially with you.
Mm-hmm. I hate that. I hate that stuff.
But I'm out of the situation now, so it doesn't really matter at this point. But in a face so full of meaning as to almost make it...
Why does that make you emotional?
In a face so full of meaning as to almost make it glow. For a good life, we just might have to weaken and find somewhere to go. Go somewhere where we're needed. Find somewhere to grow. Grow somewhere where we're needed. Like, just lyrically, this guy's so brilliant.
There was,
like,
something
look,
about it
that... Find somewhere to go, right?
Yeah.
Then the next line is, go somewhere where we're needed. Find somewhere to grow.
Yeah.
Grow somewhere where we're needed.
Yeah.
I don't know, like, the whole concept of being needed as a sort of validation of existence is a very... My mom said that one time. She said something to the effect of, like, you know. My mom was always, she's always doing that, though. She's always talking about her sister who died at 33, and, you know. So she was all, and there's just one time when my mom was like, well, she just, like, looked at all of us, and she's like, none of you guys need me anymore.
Jesus Christ.
You know, but it, you know, my mom was like, she kind of, we'd all been through so much together. And it was a crazy moment because it was true. Like, we didn't need her in the sense of, like, the typical role of a, you know, mom, like, that takes care of you type of thing.
Like, if you're a baby or a child, you mean?
Yeah, like, we were no longer dependent on her for the essentials. But obviously, you know, obviously we needed her, you know?
Yeah.
I'm not the same person, you know, and none of us are the same people. So, just one of those things, man, where it's like, I don't know. Anyway, it's just very, 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 very meaningful song. I have no idea why. But, like, this song to me is like...
I felt your warmth, too, when the song was going on.
This song to me is like one of those, like, it can grow with you type of songs. Mm-hmm. Like, this is a classic, classic song. I promise you, I'm not really going,
like,
to say much more.
When
about
you
it.
Talk about Holden.
Holden Caulfield from the book?
Yeah.
Catcher in the Rye?
Catcher in the Rye, yeah. Whenever you talk about that, there's a certain feeling that comes with it.
Yeah.
Like, a certain energy, like, comes in the room, and it's kind of sad, but kind of hopeful, and there's the bright color of red, but there's also the plain colors of just grays and blacks and whites, and I don't know, when you talk about it, it kind of has that energy, and this kind of kept a little bit of that energy too.
Yeah.
So something about the past. I don't know. I can't even describe it. And honestly, I don't even like saying anything about it because I feel like I'm discrediting the way that I feel about it. There are some things that words can't communicate what you feel. This and this is one weirdest, of those situations.
Such a weird song to me.
I agree with you. That's what I'm saying. Like, I don't even want to talk much more about it.
I wasn't listening to the lyrics, you know, as usual when I was hearing the song. It was just feeling it and just going somewhere.
What do you got after this? Oh, you got dinner.
Yeah, I have to cook.
Good. This is excellent.
For you? Because you get to sit here and listen to the music?
I'm going
to
be in my shower doing it. Listening to this song.
Let me take a shower first before you go in. Anyway, you guys don't need to hear our conversation about showers. Mukhmed, this one was an excellent one. Actually, you know what? It makes me a little bit sad.
I know. I feel like that's some of it. Like, it's weird that we've done so many songs with the guy.
Right, where we said his name, Mukhmed.
It's Mukhmed. Mukhmed.
Yeah.
I said, what? What's the kid's name?
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe. It's ridiculous. It's not going anywhere.
I'm pretty sure that there's like a sneaky way that you can like stop giving on Patreon but still be a follower. Like once you've already been in. Well, no, there's no way to keep him in there. I don't know how to do that. If you can figure out how to do that, like do it so you can still be around on Patreon.
No, just text me, bro. VenusStory@gmail.com.
Well, I'm not in that email.
Because I want you to keep up with me and tell me how your band's doing and all that shit.
All right, so put your name, Mukhmed, in the subject so he'll find it. VenusStory@gmail.com.
Yeah, send me an email and then we'll be able to keep in touch. I think that might be a little bit of
I think it is. Yeah, it's very weird.
He's not doing a request for a while or whatever, so like, I don't know. That might be a little bit of it. It's so weird, this whole internet thing. I want to be out of this review. Let's get out of this review. I'm done with this review.
All right. We love you. Have a good night.
The song's in 11 for me. I love it.
Rating it. Yeah, me too. 11.
For a very, very long time.
Yeah, 11 for sure.
Yeah, dude, seriously, though. Give me an email. I promise you I'm not going to blow up your phone, man. Just, you know, once in a while, text me. Let me know how your band's doing, all that shit. There you are, dear listener. Vin out.
Story out.
Gone.